throwing these out at you because they are stats that are kind of interesting. You look at them and then you say, well, I wonder how it's going to go when they play each other. Here's a chance and a goal on the rebound for Vincent Lecavalier.
This is almost a highlight of what Sidney Crosby did on the opening goal for the Pittsburgh Penguins. And for Mike Johnston, you want your guys paying attention, watching Lecavalier in a faceoff situation. He bumps Spaulding, and then Belmar goes to work. Lecavalier is eventually going to get to the net off the Belmar shot and stick it right by Mark Fleury.
Right off the draw. There's Lecavalier, Pierre made mention. One-on-one, you lose the draw, you got to stay with your centerman. Lecavalier causes separation. Cannot leave a guy open there.
Especially Patrick Elliott.
Right.
36th career goal against the Flyers. Here come the Flyers, 2-on-1. Lecavalier and Shen. Lecavalier in the shot. He scores! There's your answer. And we're tied again. Later, the Flyers tie it at 4 as Lecavalier scores for a case of Tasty King.
There's a reason there's an A on Wayne Simmons' jersey. And what a play he makes on the wall here. He's going to take the hit from Salvador. Salvador's drawn to Simmons. That opens up all the space for Lecavalier. He makes a great decision here. Here's the work by Simmons. And then Lecavalier looks off Braden Shen and buries that one to the blocker side.
Yeah, taking a hit to me.
Boys will take this draw against Lecavalier. And Brad Boys won it. Oh, is that big? Mitchell around the boards. But it's held in the zone again. Giroux flips it in front. Loose puck there. Put on goal and they score. Lecavalier jammed it home with 7.4 left. It is now a one-goal game, but just 7.4 seconds to go. Finally, the Flyers, who seemed to have a man advantage or two the entire third period.
The entire third period. What I find amazing, though, are the defensemen of the Flyers. How Delzato and Strider have been able to keep the puck in the zone time and time again. There you see the puck being pushed into the net by the veteran Lecavalier.
Mark Strider with a head manning pass to Lecavalier. Gains the line. And back around. Braden Shen to Lecavalier, and he scores! Vinny Lecavalier, in his return to Tampa Bay, does get himself a goal. He gets the Flyers on the board. That patented one-timer of his. His ninth goal of the year. It's 3-1. Lecavalier scores for a case of Tasty King.
And typical of a guy that understands the predicament that the Flyers are in this game, Vinny Lecavalier didn't even raise his arms. He's made this a 3-1 game, but they're running out of time. And you know, so many times Vinny Lecavalier scrapes the rafters with the windup for his one-timer. Didn't have to on this one. He just caught it a couple of feet back. Sing.
On that last shift, there's a chance of French score! Vinny Lecavalier has tied this game at 3, his second point of the game.
Well, the Jets win the draw to just give the puck away right in front to Lecavalier. He's left all alone with Andre Pavlik, and he gets his third goal of the year and third of the game to tie this one up at 3s. Faceoff, Lowry wins it. There's a Kane taps it back. Instead of taking it, it goes off. Looks like Harrison coming off the wall with Vandevelde. And as Kane puts it back, Vandevelde just shovels it out front. Lecavalier all alone, and he puts it past the blocker.
Charlie Coyle had a power play goal earlier in the game for Minnesota. At the time, it was the tying goal. Got Minnesota even at 2. This one trickles through Kemper. A shot from the point that was tipped on the way. Looks like Lecavalier will have his third goal in the last two nights, and it's a two-goal Philadelphia lead.
Looks like he even reached back behind him and deflected that one. Lecavalier, like I said, it's, have a guy that deep in your lineup. McDonald just takes a wrister here, and you look at him reach behind him and tip that downwards. My goodness. I mean, Falk pretty much had him contained. And all that's left is the stick, and he deflects it downwards and into the net.
Building. Flyers with the puck to the point.
one-timer by Lawton. He scores.
Or excuse me, Lecavalier scores the goal. And the Flyers,
2 one-timers,
have beaten Varlamov and the Avs in this game, and now it's 2-2.
Mikey, it was interesting. When the Avalanche were in Philadelphia, they were having their morning skate, and I watched Lecavalier shoot pucks from exactly this spot. He must have shot 100 of them.
And Matt Reed will penetrate the zone, gets around it. Check attempt, finds Delzato for the shot! And he missed it. All the way out to McDonald again. And the pass, Lecavalier, and he scores! Still has that scoring touch. Vinny Lecavalier remains hot as he beat Schneider to make it a 5-2 game. Lecavalier with 5 goals in his last 7 games. Scores for a case of Tasty Cake.
Greg Berube elects to keep Vinny Lecavalier in the second power play unit. And he's pretty comfortable there. Does a nice job walking off the wall there in the quick snapshot with Umberger providing a screen in front.
Yeah, all Umberger there, taking away the eyes of Corey Schneider.
1-for-3 on the season. Side to side and on goal. Scores! Put it on the forehand and shelved it to give the Flyers the advantage.
Jumping in with Lecavalier. And Couturier gets his own shoot in. Loosey behind the Buffalo goal. Banks that back to Timonen. Timo Timonen's shot bounces down in front. Ebros save! And Couturier kicks out of Ebros. Still down. The puck is loose. Got back in front. Lecavalier scores! Vincent Lecavalier with 14 seconds left puts the Flyers back on top. And boy, did his team need that, and boy, did he need that. His first goal since November 27th, almost 2 months, gives the Flyers the lead.
Well, he had a shot earlier on, just before he scores the goal, and that had the Buffalo Sabres off balance and ended up behind the net. There's the shot. That looked like it hit the shaft of the stick almost by Enroth. Enroth, no stick again, has trouble getting up in time, and in fact, cannot. A seeing-eye shot from Lecavalier, but a nice pass there from Matt Reed. Sabres in the shooting zone. Look at that. 4 players, but it's a seeing-eye shot that goes in between all 4 Buffalo defenders. Enroth really struggling to get back up on his feet, and that one goes top shelf. The right idea by Vinny Lecavalier. He knew he wanted to get it up top. Nice play by Reed to fish it out from behind the net. And Buffalo is back.
93 career goals. 2 goals against the Blue Jackets. Far side. One-timer Lecavalier. He shoots and scores. It's a power play goal. And the Flyers have their first lead.
And that's what they've been waiting for Vincent Lecavalier, who has been in a goalless drought. But you can see good puck movement. They get the thing out high. They utilize the wingers wide. And then the one-timer by Lecavalier. Again, the faceoff won by Philadelphia. You see Shen being able to move it. Lecavalier, he kicks himself out along the half-board. And then the movement back to the point. And then once you get the defense moving back and forth, they find the seam backside. That's where an active stick. You want to be able to take away this pass right there. But unable to do so.
Philadelphia has given up the second most shorthanded goals in the entire National Hockey League coming into tonight. They've surrendered 8 this season. Anaheim hasn't had much pressure that way. As Gustafson drives, gets it across, and they score. Lecavalier able to trickle it through. Anderson got a piece.
They just jinxed it. This punt goes through the 5 hole. Lecavalier collects it, has the time to really tee it up. Cross ice pass, the Ducks beaten on a pass at the blue line, and it goes through the 5 hole. Anderson gets a little piece of it. You know, to close that 5 hole up, goaltenders have to get both knees down on the ice. The pads will seal it up. And you can see, boy, that the angle from behind the net really showed that Anderson was just a split second late getting to the ice, and the 5 hole was available.
Out to Braden Shen, all the way across it goes. Here's Strike, dropping it off for Simmons for the shot. Deflection! Shen scores! The light does go on, and now it is a goal. A little hesitation from the referee, but it is a goal. Braden Shen going hard to the net. Dave Jackson having a conversation here. There was hesitation, Jonesy, as to whether or not this was a goal.
Because I think Strowman put it in his own net. Braden Shen was driving to find the rebound after the tip by Lecavalier. Let's see if Shen shoots it or not. There's Strawman's stick, and he puts it in past Henrik Lundqvist. It's the
NHL action here on NBC. Heeman in across the line. Hands it off. Shot here. Score! Lecavalier with a wrist shot. It looked pretty innocent, but it beats Holtby, and the Flyers complete the comeback and win it in overtime. It looked to me like this last shot was actually deflected. It's a wrist shot. Holtby didn't see it, but it looked like it hit the shin pad.
Clear because of that. What chances for the Flyers there?
Might have saved Vitali there as Colburn was leaning into that slap shot. Vitali was in a real vulnerable spot.
Stretch pass ahead. Lecavalier in the shot. He scores! There was going to be a penalty. It doesn't matter. Lecavalier, that's his 15th in the Flyers lead. 3-0. Lecavalier for a case of tasty cake.
A great job by Vinny Lecavalier there. He elevates the puck for the third time in this game. The Flyers beat Marc-Andre Fleury upstairs. Look at the pass here from Luke Shen. Tape to tape, right on the money, and Vinny walks in and does the rest of the work.
And he does a great job of protecting.
One shot apiece, no goals, of course, and the 50-50 is worth over $22,000 already. Bouncer comes, they put it all up there, don't they? Jammed on ahead now for the Flyer possession and carried back in for Lecavalier. Scores! And that, for him, is number 400.
17th goal this season, as Doc said, is 400. Bad puck play by the Bruins, and then Vinny Lecavalier fools Tuukka Rask. Adam Hall gives it up, drives to the net. It might have touched the stick on the way in, and maybe that's why it baffled Tuukka Rask. Johnny Boychuk's stick might have affected the flight of the puck.
The net is empty in front of that pass from Voracek on to Tiemannin. Moves back up with 35. Voracek with speed, trying to get away from Louis Eriksson. Plops one along that Chara is able to send along, and it bounced free. They can't get out with it, though. Boychuk missed on it. Puck taken by Voracek, side of the net. They score! Second of the day for him. 400th first of his career. Third and tying goal for his team.
Follow the bouncing puck. The Bruins can't corral it. The Flyers can. It's bouncing all over. And you see it bounce away. And then eventually Vinny Lecavalier says, thank you very much. Bouncing puck there. Bouncing puck there. Bouncing puck there. Jake Voracek hard on it. We talked about five forwards and one defenseman. And the extra guy, Voracek's the one that kept it alive and got it over to Vinny Lecavalier, who ties it up.
Well, that was a clean win a moment ago for Cody Hodgson as well.
Mason has it, drops it quickly, pushes it ahead. Flyers trying to catch the Sabres on a chance. Lecavalier scores! What a shot by Vinny Lecavalier! It's 4-0.
Line changes and then the quick ups in second periods when you're a long way from your bench is the story here. I think this shot gets deflected by Weber as well. The line change by the Sabres, you'll see left side of your screen, a wholesale change. Look at the quick pass, they get Vinny Lecavalier there. Weber comes across, and the way the trajectory of it, it just looks to me that it may have gone off his stick and right up under the bar. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, it did. It ramped right up the stick.
Cody finds it. He's number one on that list. There's a turnover by Roback. Hall is steal. The shot, the save, the rebound. Lecavalier, they score! Vinny Lecavalier pouncing on the rebound. And if it's his goal, it's now 7 Flyers with 20 goals on the season. As they score for a case of tasty cake, it's 1-0 Flyers.
Looked like Vinny turned around to confirm whether or not it was his goal because Adam Hall was in front. But a good forecheck by Adam Hall made all of this happen. Yeah, I don't think anybody touched it.
Right there, you're going to see Lecavalier come in late. and Dan Ellis has no idea where that puck is, and it just goes right through the 5-0 and dribbles.
Here's Braden Shen back on the ice. That's good news for the Flyers, but hard into the boards. Moments to go. Out to the right point, Strike has room. Goes behind the back, now to Lecavalier. Across to McDonald, and then Strike. Lecavalier with a shot, deflected, score! The Flyers beat Lundqvist on the power play. It is now 3-1.
Some good puck movement there by the Philadelphia Flyers, and I think this goes in off of Kevin Klein's stick. They get the power play moving from side to side, in the middle, off to the side, then back to the point. Again, there's the fake shot, and then the one-timer by Vinny Lecavalier. Here's where it's redirected. Yeah, it's Klein in front of the net, definitely a redirection. I'm not even sure that original shot was going to go on net, but Klein, in trying to block it, inadvertently changes its direction and puts it in behind Lundqvist.